Welcome to the second module of chapter motion. In this module, we shall discuss the topic describing motion. Points to be discussed are position and reference point, distance traveled or path length, and displacement. Let us look at the following scenario. Four friends are sitting around a table with one person on each side. Let's call them as A, B, C, and D. The tablecloth that is placed on the table is white and has no markings. An ant has been placed by one of the friends and it started moving from that position. A started describing the motion of the ant. A says the ant is moving to right. B says ant is moving to left. And C says ant is moving towards me. And D says the ant is moving away from me. After a discussion, they agree to do something. They have marked a point on the center of the table and they drew two lines perpendicular to each other, passing through the center. They have marked the directions as north, south, east, and west. And the divisions are made by lines. After this, describing the motion of ant became easy. If one indicates the direction, and it will be the same for everyone else. From this, we understand how important a reference point is in a motion. Here, reference point was the point where the two lines met. Now we will understand the motion along a straight line. Consider a car moving from X, then it moves to R, then to Q, and then back to P. The total distance traveled by car or path length of the car in this motion is 40 units from X to P, 20 units from P to Q, 5 units from Q to R, and 25 units from R to P, a total of 90 units. In physics, the word distance indicates how much an object moves irrespective of its direction with respect to a reference point. Another way of describing motion is by identifying the displacement of the object. Displacement, on the other hand, needs both magnitude and direction for its description. In the example, we see the object has moved just 40 units, comparing the initial and final position of the whole journey. So, displacement is 40 units to the right, as it is the straight line distance between initial and final points. Now let us have an activity to understand distance and displacement in detail. Take a long rope and a meter scale. Choose a rectangular shaped place just like a tennis court. Move from one corner to another along the sides. Take the rope along with you when moving. After moving to the other end, use the scale to measure the length of the rope. This will give you the total distance traveled. Now fix the rope at one corner of the court and move to the other corner. Measure the length of the rope. This is your displacement, because displacement is the distance between the starting point and the end point, or shortest or straight line distance between initial and final position. The displacement can be directly calculated by applying Pythagoras' theorem. Hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus altitude square. Applying the values for AB, BC and AC is calculated to be root of A square plus B square, and the value will be equal to 26.4. Here the displacement is equal to the length of the diagonal of the square field. Now we shall differentiate distance and displacement. Distance is the length of the path traveled by a body while moving from initial position to final position. Displacement is the shortest distance between initial and final position. Distance is a scalar, displacement is a vector. Distance measured is always positive. Displacement can be positive or negative based on the reference point. There is always a distance covered whenever there is a motion. Displacement can be zero if the object is coming back to its initial position. SI unit of distance is meter. SI unit of displacement is also meter. Here we have some questions. That is, when do we say that an object is in motion or rest? Motion and rest are relative terms. Justify. Distinguish between scalars and vector. Distinguish between distance and displacement. Try to answer these questions. So in this module, we have studied the ways of describing motion. Thank you.